Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm John. Today I'm going to continue finish this artwork by adding more details and material to the cylinder and the floor. Without further ado, let's get started. First, select the cylinder and press tab to go into edit mode. Then select the face on the top. Then click insert faces. Then insert it. And then press E to extrude it. And then click H select, or you can press 2 on your keyboard, and then press A to select all, and then press Ctrl B to bevel the H. And then set the segment to 3. Then press Ctrl R to add a loop cut in the middle of the cylinder. And then press 3 on the numpad to see the right view, and then press alternate G to see the x-ray view. Press face select, or you can press 3 on your keyboard and then select the upper parts of the cylinder. And we want to assign a color for it. Go to material properties and press new. We can actually change the shading mode to viewport shading, so we can see the color when we apply it later. Then we click assign to assign the material onto the face polygon we selected. Then we can go to the shader editor. And then we change the base color to yellow color. And then now we select the bottom part of the cylinder. Then click the add button to add a new material, and then click new, and then click assign to assign the new material to the selected polygon faces. And then we change the base color to maybe bluish gray color, and then press tab to exit edit mode. And then right click and click the shade smooth. And now I actually want to add a few more different color of cylinder scatter on the plane. To do this, we can press shift D and X to duplicate another cylinder. We want to apply a different color to this cylinder. Select the material and press the 2 button here to make a single user copy, and then we change the color to a lighter green. And then now we select another material and press the 2 button to make a single user copy again, and we can adjust this base color to slightly green. You don't have to follow me exactly, you can put whatever color you want. Okay, and then we do the same thing again. Press Shift D and X to duplicate another cylinder. Select the material and press 2 button and change the base color to light gray color. Select another material and press 2 button again and make the color to darker gray. Just slightly darker is enough. And then select 3 of the cylinder and press M to move it into a new collection. Name it clone object and press OK. And now we can start to clone 3 of this cylinder randomly onto the plane here. So now select the plane and go to geometry node. Go to point instance and click collection and select the clone object. And remember to untick the whole collection, and you can play with the seed value and see which color matching is better. Okay, this is better for me. You can choose whatever value you want as long as you like the matching. Okay, now I want to add some hole to the plane. So where the cylinder scale bigger, the hole will be scaled at the same time. To do this, first we need to make the plane bigger, and now we need to add a transform node to the plane. And change the scale to 2.9. Maybe we can move this out from the plane. And we can make the Z axis slightly higher, put it 0.4. And now we can add a boolean node. And then press Shift D to duplicate the point instance. Connect the geometry from attribute max to the point instance. Change this to object. Connect the geometry from point instance to boolean. And now we want to add another instance object for boolean. So press 7 to see the top view. Press Shift A and add a cylinder. Change the vertices to 6. Radius to 0.8. And depth to 4. And now we can add in the instant object to the point instance here. Then to make the point instance node clear, we can actually add a name to the nodes. Select the nodes, go to the node tab, and in the label column, type instance for boolean. Select another point instance and rename the label to instance for cloner. And now we finish the boolean parts. Okay, next we want to add material onto the floor. So select the floor and go to material properties tab, add a new material, go to shader editor, change the base color to light blue color. And then add a bump node, then connect it to normal, and then add a brick texture. Connect the color to height and change the scale to 22 to make it smaller. And now we can add a camera to the scene. Press Shift A and add a camera, and then press Control Alternate 0 to frame the view you are looking now, and then you can adjust the camera. And then we can change the focal length to 150. I want it to be more isometric view, zoom out a bit so we can see everything. And then I'm going to change the renderer to cycles. Change the device to GPU. And then now we are going to add a light. Press numpad 7 to switch to top view. And then press Shift A and add a area light. Press numpad 0 to switch back to camera view. And then press viewport shading. Select the light and go to light properties. Then change the power to 444 and the size to 3. And then go to the world properties panel and change the background color to slightly blue. And then now we want to add an emission light at the below the floor, but before this maybe we can adjust the light higher. Press Shift A and add a plane. Press S to make it bigger. Press G and Z to move it below the floor. go to material properties and add a new material. In the shader editor, delete the existing principal node and add a emission shader. Connect the emission to the surface. Change the color to light green color. And change the strength to 6 maybe. And now we want to add some thickness to the floor. In order to do this, go to modifier properties and add a solidify modifiers. Now we can see the thickness. Untick the fill and drag the solidify modifier above the geometry nodes. Maybe put the thickness to 0.11. Okay, and now we've done it. So if you like my video, please subscribe and see you next week. Bye.